We have to subtract 36.87 from 51.01. So on the top we have 51.01. From greater number we subtract smaller. 36.87. Underline. And now, how we subtract decimal numbers? First, we write them in vertical columns, aligning the decimal points. Decimal points we have in the same column. Next, we have to check if we have on the top numbers greater than on the bottom. We use the same rule like for subtraction whole numbers. 1 is less than 7, so we need to do borrowing. We borrow 1 from next column, but we have 0 here. So we go to next digit and we trick these two digits like one number. So we have 10 minus 1 is 9. So we have 9 here and here will be 0 now. And now when we borrow 1 from next digit, so we have 11 at the end. And again we check 11 minus 7, okay, 9 minus 8 will be okay, 0 minus 6, no. We have to borrow 1 from next digit, so it will be now 5 minus 1 is 4, and here we will have 10 now. So we have 11 minus 7, we start from the last column and we going to the left side. So 11 minus 7 is 4, 9 minus 8 is 1, we keep decimal point, 10 minus 6 is 4, 4 minus 3 is 1. Next we have to check 14.14 plus 36.87. How we add decimal numbers? We have to write them first in vertical columns aligning decimal points. Next we have to start from the last column. We are going to the left and we add like whole numbers. So 4 plus 7 is 11. So we write 1 and we add 1 to next column. 1 plus 1 plus 8. So this is 10. So we have to write 0. Copy decimal point and we add 1 to next column. 1 plus 4 is 5 plus 6 is 11. So we have 1 and we add 1 to next column. So this is 2, 3. So it will be 5. The same. We have the same number which we have at the beginning. So our solution 14.14 is correct.